Welcome back to Let's Play Snatcher Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're going to leave. We'll be careful. We're headed to... Should we head to Ivan's apartment or Freddy's apartment? Ivan is the professional or amateur air surfer. Freddy is a cab driver with a wife. I'm not sure. Freddy looks more like it, but Ivan is an air surfer, maybe more important. Lives by himself. Let's head for Ivan. Now heading to Ivan Rodriguez's apartment. We have arrived. This is Ivan Rodriguez's neighborhood. According to the data in Jordan, this should be his neighborhood. Ugh, this place is a real slum. District data retrieval networks haven't been installed in this area. As such, there is virtually no data on the area in the Alpha 1 network. This region is almost completely isolated. I wonder if anybody is actually living in this area. Well, these people probably are. There is no sign that there has been any maintenance work in some time. It's been completely neglected. The place is utterly filthy. There are a few freemen here. Freemen? What are they? We have freemen now. One of the focal points of the Neo Kobe North-South problem. Alright, let's see about the freemen. Their actual lifestyle is not unlike that of the homeless. See, they're gathered around a fire. How are they different from the homeless? Unlike the less fortunate, these people have chosen to live like this, often leaving good jobs to do so. It appears to be a form of rebellion towards the over-control of information by the central authorities. They are one of Neo Kobe's biggest problems. Maybe they know something. Why don't we ask them? Their actual lifestyle is not unlike the... They appear to be burning something in an empty barrel. Well, it gets pretty cold at night this time of year. I just hope they don't inadvertently start a bigger fire. I think we'll be okay. There appear to be some modifications to the structure. It's in violation of building codes. This area is an officially recognized slum. It is outside of the Municipal Data Administration districts. They don't appear to have any problem with illegal parking, more like illegal abandonment. Many people apparently still live in there, and most seem reluctant to move on. Be careful. Hazardous smoke is also being emitted by the fire. That's because they probably burn anything they find around here. These abandoned cars are probably next. I think it'll be hard to burn. There appear to be several hypodermic needles among the ashes. What's this? Gillian says, what? Drugs even in neighborhoods this poor? I read traces of liquid sky. It's an illegal stimulant. Oh, he was analyzing that. Should have recognized the sound. They probably keep the fire going all day long. Keep the fire burning! Keep the fire... What? You actually want me to investigate him? That's right. Please, Gillian, be reasonable. Check it out real careful, okay? Ah! This reeks! Hey! What do you think you're doing? There's nothing suspicious here, just filth and grime. And the kind of tough grease that no ordinary household cleanser can match. That's why new Melt It with hydrochloric action can handle all the heavy jobs. Gillian, your stupid attempts at humor are more irritating than funny. Yeah? Something that stinks. Yes, it sure does. They do not appear to have anything. Ugh, my olfactory sensors are nearing overload. Let's ask about Gibson first. Hey! You guys! What? I need to talk to you. Yeah? Who's that? I don't know. I have trouble with my own name these days. This guy really needs help. Could you tell me anything you know about a man named Ivan Rodriguez? Was there anybody named that around here? You lie to me and you'll live to regret it. Now, now, calm yourself. I'm trying to remember. Well, can you recall anything? Not yet. I need money. Have you heard anything about snatchers in this area? Snatchers? Don't be stupid. If there were any around here, you think they'd come after us? You're probably right. There's nobody around here worth going after. Nobody worries about them in these parts. These here parts. How long have you been living around here? I used to be part of the development team that put together the Alpha 1 network. So you were a programmer, huh? What happened? One day I took a peek at some secret data in Alpha 1. That's impossible, Metal Gear says. Security on the system is... It was possible for me. Anyhow, I saw enough garbage and scum on people in this society and that file to last me a lifetime. People. They can sink really low, you know. You may be right, Killian says. Why don't you become free, too? Join us here. You ever get sick of it all? Just drop by. I've got to get my pass back before I can become free. Alpha 1 has data on the development team in there. Take a look at it when you get a chance. Hmm. And where, in this building? How long do you plan on staying around here? I'm not like the rest of these guys. I want to work. I just can't find any jobs. No ID, right? That's right. They won't even see me down at the unemployment benefits office. Find me a job, will you? Are you an immigrant? As illegal as they come. I heard all these great stories about the place. Had a lot of dreams. Now look at me. What about you? Me? I just cut loose on my own, you know. I just couldn't take any more of anything. My family, my job, I was sick of it all. Here, I feel like I've gone back to my childhood. It's great. Every morning when I get up, I can actually decide what I want to do. No schedules, man. Every day is a blank slate. Blank slate, huh? Yeah, I really feel alive.
You say so.
What about that old guy? Him? He was abandoned by his son and daughter-in-law. Abandoned? Yeah, he was in some home for old people, but they couldn't afford the payments, so they just dumped him here. It's like a garbage heap for the elderly. That's inhuman. We're taking care of him. You know, sometimes he calls out his son's name in the middle of the night. Yeah, we know the video phone number of his son. Why don't you give them a call for us? Let's see, the number's 30-2501. Okay, I will. Sounds good to me. 0-2501 Old Man's Son. Got it. Alright, if I have some time. Help us out, okay? It's for the old guy's sake. Gillian, I think that's enough. It's not enough, dammit! Alright. Ask about drugs. Are drugs available in this area? Yeah, but they're way too pricey for us to buy. There's a few buyers in the neighborhood. Happens all the time around here. Show him the mask. Whoa! Caught me by surprise there! Don't you have anything better than that? Not really. Well, isn't this fun? Don't you have anything to eat? And what's this? Gibson's photo. Has something happened? What are you talking about? Something happened. Who's that? Do you know this man? That's that idiot Ivan. Yeah, that's the fool himself. That's definitely Ivan. No mistake there. Do you have anything better than that? Let's make this call. You should dial this number. Hello? This is Investigator Seed. Investigator? It's about your father. Silence. He wants to come home. If you leave him where he is, I don't think he'll be around much longer. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Yes. This is your own father I'm talking about. Is he doing all right? No, he's not. As a matter of fact, he looks ill. Is that so? I'm sure you two must have had some problems, but he's still your father, right? Thank you for taking the trouble of informing me of the situation, Investigator. Gillian says, despite how poorly you've treated him, your father still calls out your name every day. Really? Pop does that? Forgive me. Pop, please forgive me. Where is he? He's in the South Etayado area of the SN District. Go and take him home. Yes, I will. I'm leaving right now. I can't thank you enough. Thank me by taking good care of your dad this time. You did a good thing, Gillian. Wonder if you can follow up. Never mind. Search for Ivan. Where would we even begin to look for him around here? I have no data on this area. We should try asking somebody. Where does Ivan live? He's in apartment 301 of this building. That's the kid with the weird board thing, right? Alright, 301. You mean the guy who's into Sky, don't you? I hear he's always surfing. Oh, that guy, huh? Metal Gear says, I'm not sure I understand what you're talking about. He seems to have come into some money lately. I've never been able to figure him out. Room 301. Alright, let's head for apartment 301. Third floor, huh? Well, he won't be able to escape out the window. Might be a fire escape. We're at the door to apartment 301. Plate? It says apartment 301, Ivan Rodriguez. It's an old-style door with a small peephole viewer installed. If someone is watching from the inside, we should be able to see his eye. There's an electric meter. It appears to be for this apartment. There's a small window to one side of the door. That's why I keep looking repeatedly, because first you find the meter, then you find the window. Both apartments on either side appear to be abandoned. There's an old-style electric meter. The amount of electricity used is displayed visually by a counter and wheel mechanism. Since we are outside of any municipal data administration district, it would appear that the electric company has to bill individual users manually. How terrible for them. Something is covering the window from the inside. It's impossible to see in. It's impossible to tell whether the lights are on or not. Can I investigate? It's the door plate for apartment 301. It's handwritten, but accurate. This is definitely Ivan Rodriguez's apartment. Gillian, why don't we try knocking? Not yet. I'm investigating. The door is locked. Since we do not have a warrant, we can't open it unless we have a key. Oh. Good to know. I don't want to violate any, junker protocol. Wait a minute. Electricity is being used. I read motion. Somebody is in the apartment. Damn it. There's definitely someone in there. It's locked. It appears to have been closed for some time. Knocking? What if I just leave? I'll knock on the door. There is no answer. That's funny. Who's there? There's a man looking through from the other side. Perhaps it is Ivan. Since we do not have a warrant, we can't open it unless we have a key. Ivan Rodriguez, I'm a junker. Open up. I've got a few questions to ask you.
What do you want?
First, you open this door.
Alright, alright. Just relax.
Are you prepared, Gillian? It isn't insectors you're up against this time. Yeah, I know. And I don't want any more of those nanomachine injections either.
Sorry it took so long.
Gillian, watch out! Wait. Well, that was easy. He's just a regular guy, maybe?
Did I kill him?
He has only lost consciousness. Excellent shot, Gillian, hitting him in the hand like that.
That's not exactly how I planned it.
No, it isn't. Threaten with gun. Investigate, interrogate. He looks just like the montage, but he has quite a suntan. Is it possible for a snatcher to get a suntan like this? Probably not. It's probably not him. This room's really dark. I don't see anything suspicious, though. The room is quite filthy. Wait, there's some trophies over here. No matter where you look, everything seems covered with grime. It's a cheap ray gun purchased on the black market. I didn't know ray guns came in cheap. It says runner-up, 12th Neo Kobe Air Surfing Championships. I get it. He's an air surfer. Well, that's what it said in his entry in Jordan's computer. This doesn't look stolen. I believe it's his. I'm pretty sure it is his. There's a great deal of waste packed into an old model electric suction type cleaning device. Apparently, he isn't too concerned about cleanliness. It's a vacuum cleaner. I am unable to detect any Snow 9. There's nothing in the room to suggest that he may be a snatcher. It's a Saturday Night RG-11. This is a toy gun that has been modified to fire real shells. A very low-grade weapon. That was a stroke of good luck, wasn't it, Gillian? Gillian, sorry. I took 4 hits, but with a gun like this... It's because I didn't understand what the hell to do. I swear I hit... First I was hitting fire, and then I'm like, duh, I have to, you know, draw my gun. And the first time I pressed it, nothing happened. I don't know if that was supposed to happen, so I had to hit it again to draw the gun, and then finally, okay, now I can start shooting. Been modified to fire real shells, a very low-grade weapon. So it's not a ray gun? Well, it's a ray gun, a toy gun. Alright. A toy ray gun, alright. It appears to be a real trophy. It's just plated, so there is no real gold in it. Aged organic materials and typical secretory organisms are all I read. There is no evidence in his garbage that he is a snatcher. If he was a snatcher, there is bound to be some evidence in his garbage. Apparently there is not. Interrogate. Alright. I see no need to threaten him outright at this point. Hey! What'd you come out shooting for? I got hit 4 times back there, you know? You got the wrong guy, I swear! You're a snatcher, aren't you? I don't know what you're talking about, man! He seems to be behaving strangely. Don't let your guard down. He might be on drugs. Come on, reveal yourself, snatcher. I don't know what you're talking about, man. You got the wrong guy, I swear. Threaten with gun? Hey, don't shoot, okay? So stop that, alright? Somebody save me. Ah, stop, stop it, man. Wait a second, I can't leave. We're supposed to do something in this room. Oh, I haven't investigated Ivan yet, have I? I was kind of saving that for last. I saved it for way last. Without a scanning warrant, I cannot perform a full analysis, but a visual inspection reveals no cancerous skin lesions, despite his deep tan.
All right, buddy, time to wake up.
Oh, crap.
Oh, man, don't shoot! Don't shoot!
Gillian, while your earlier shot is justifiable as self-defense, killing this suspect would violate Section 5, Article 2 of the Junker Bylaws.
I know.
You must first have concrete evidence that he is a snatcher.
Damn.
We should search his bathroom. We may find sunscreen there.
Good point.
Okay, let's move into the bathroom.
I don't think we will. I wasn't far off at the voice either of Ivan, was I? Did he yell something out? I'm not even sure. I think it was printed on the screen, not a voice at the when we first opened the door. I'm not sure. This is Ivan's bathroom. My goodness, this place is just as disgusting as the living room. An airboard is leaning against the wall. It's really a mess. It looks like he has been washing his surf gear in here. At least he washes something. The tub is filled with dirty water. It appears completely unwashed. It's soiled in a striped pattern. Oh, I didn't investigate by mistake. I believe all efforts at personal hygiene in this bathroom would be fruitless. Futile and fruitless. Fruitless. Shelf? Wait, there's a bottle here. Maybe it is sunscreen. We don't know what it is yet. Let's look at the airboard. It's an airboard. Its design reflects the latest aeronautic technologies. This is a very expensive, high-quality piece of equipment. It seems quite out of place in this room. I don't want to look at the bottle yet. The floor is absolutely filthy. It looks more like the floor of a cattle barn than of a bathroom. Oh my, what's this? What? Did you find a snake scale or something? This filth. I'll be having nightmares about it. Not only is it filthy, but it has become discolored. Isn't that the same thing? Well, the board has been very well maintained. It's quite shiny from several layers of wax. Residue in tub. I detect numerous organic residue and organisms in the water residue here. There is no evidence that he is a snatcher here. The water residue registers the same as the garbage examined earlier. Nothing unusual detected. What a horrible smell. Based on your reaction, I would say there is no Snow 9 here either. There was no pollen in the room that indicate the presence of a snatcher. Alright, let's look at the bottle. There is no label. The bottle differs significantly from the one at John's house. Investigate. Metal, analyze the contents of this for me, will you? Can we do that without a warrant? I guess so. It's not sunscreen, it's suntan oil. It shows no signs of having been used recently. Sunscreen and suntan oil are like day and night. Yes, they are. I don't think he's our man. It's a standard commercial suntan oil product. The label on the bottle confirms this. It's not sunscreen, it's suntan oil, designed to enhance the sun's effects. can't leave the room yet, though. What did I not do yet? I can't just exit the room. There's gotta be something we have to do in here. Looks more like the floor of a cattle barn than of a bathroom. What's so funny? Just check it out for me, Gillian says. There's a crack on the bottom of the board. Something seems to be jutting out. It's a plastic bag. Drugs? There was some kind of powder in it. These are illegal drugs. And not only that, it looks like liquid sky, that powerful stimulant that is killing a lot of its addicts. So the story we heard from the people outside was true.
So that about explains everything, doesn't it?
Yes. It appears that Ivan was simply trying to conceal the fact that he is a drug user.
An air surfer, huh? Plenty of suntan oil. Out there soaking up lots of ultraviolet rays.
And tanned quite brown by those rays as well.
But he doesn't have so much as a pimple. Not what I'd call your typical artificial skin user.
Ivan is apparently not a snatcher.
All right, buddy, get up.
We're back to this.
Hey, I only do liquid sky, dude. Just once in a while. I swear. I don't touch anything else. Don't hurt me, man. Come on. Call me an ambulance, will ya?
I'm no cop, I'm a junker.
So violent.
I couldn't care less if you're a buyer, a pusher, or what. What I want to know is if you're a snatcher or human.
Gillian, Ivan's skin is healthy. There is no way he could be a snatcher and tan like that without developing melanoma.
Yeah, really.
However,
you should know that by now.
HQ has just transmitted us a scanning warrant. Therefore, under the provisions of Section 18 of the Civil Code, Snatchers and the Protection of Citizens' Rights, I will hereby commence a full bioscan of Ivan.
Okay.
Analysis complete. Ivan Rodriguez is a completely normal Homo sapien.
We knew that. It's not necessary.
I keep telling you, dude, I ain't no snatcher or whatever. Now, would you please get me a doctor?
Why don't you just put some of your drugs on it?
Oh, God.
I wasn't doing anything wrong, man.
The friendly boys from narcotics will be here any time now. Save your breath for them.
Come on, dude. I ain't done nothing. I'm just into air surfing. I just wanted to win the competition, man. I needed some money for that, okay? Hey, it's just drugs, man.
Tell it to the feds.
Well, Ivan Rodriguez sure wasn't our man.
Too bad for him that he happened to look like the snatcher we're after. That leaves Freddy Nielsen.
Okay. Guess we're headed for Freddy Nielsen next. I am not ready to fight these things. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. This is an awesome little one-shot episode. I love it. See you the next time, guys, and always seek adventure.